I'm John Steichen. I'm a senior research fellow in DuPont Qualicon, and I specialize in the detection and characterization of microbes through molecular devices. The RiboPrinter is a product that can look at the genetic characteristics of an organism in a food sample and find out if that has ever been seen before in that particular plant through a previous analysis. It's a way of identifying a specific subtype of an organism and determining whether it's ever been observed before. That's very important in tracking the source of a contamination in a food processing flow, or identifying where in the world that pathogen might have come from. The RiboPrinter system can then go and say specifically where did that organism, the Listeria monocytogenes, come from in a plant in order to avoid listeriosis in people. A RiboPrinter differs from those other techniques in providing a very fast response requiring minimal technical expertise in running the instrument and the technology. I love Parma ham and melon. And one of the problems is that in the wintertime, my Parma ham comes from Italy and my melons come from Central or South America. And in order to know that I'm getting good material coming to the dinner table, I need to have those things tested. The RiboPrinter is a device that can be used for tracing back to the source where the contamination occurred. It does that by looking at the very fine detail of the genetic structure of the organism, so the two Listeria monocytogenes are not the same to the RiboPrinter. The RiboPrinter can differentiate the subtypes and say that in a production facility, that organism didn't come from a conveyor, didn't come from the water supply, but came from a cold water pipe in the ceiling. The RiboPrinter system is completely automated. The customer is only required to place a sample in it, and all of the preparation, all of the PCR processes, all of the other processes are automatically determined. The customer can introduce a sample about every 2 hours. It takes 8 hours to develop, and the throughput on a system is about 32 samples a day. If the organism has never been seen before, it can be put into the customer's database so the customer can come back and see if in the future it will be found, or it can go into an international database of 6,900 patterns, which are stored by DuPont Qualicon. And other customers or that customer can go back in the future and say, yes, October 10th, 2010, I saw that in a plant in Malaysia. DuPont Qualicon needs to be able to come up with techniques for identifying these organisms and producing tests rapidly that can be used by the food processors, by the government institutes, by researchers in finding these in foods.